Hi everybody, I'm John Wake with HomeSmart. Let's talk about what the Phoenix metro real estate market is going to look like in 2016. In 2015, I expected it to be kind of a normal year with price increases, maybe 3, 4, 5% at the most. Turns out it's going to be 8%. So I kind of blew that estimate. The previous year I really nailed it, and a couple years before that I called the bottom really well. Here's the problem. I expected that the price increases that we saw in 2015 would mean that there would be more homes hitting the market. Well, so far, we're in November now, we haven't seen it. In fact, they're a little bit less than they were a year ago at this time. And I expected them to be actually quite a bit more than they were a year ago at this time. So the supply of homes is slow, it's tight. It's less than 4 months supply of homes, when in November it really should be more than that. So that would suggest that prices are gonna be really strong once the high season starts in January. We'll see good price increases. But I'm a little worried about big price increases. As you can see on this graph about inflation-adjusted prices, they were already pretty high. We're higher on inflation-adjusted basis than homes in the early part of the 2000s. Although higher prices are good for sellers, they're not good for buyers. And if it leads to future price declines, that's a bad thing as well. So a lot of people are talking about interest rates will slow down the market. And there's kind of a general expectation, maybe 70% chance people are saying that the Fed will increase interest rates in December, and then that will cause mortgage rates to increase to a degree as well. But it's not very much. It was like a quarter of a percentage point. But will that really put the tamp down on rising home prices? I'm not so sure it would. Because I remember what it was like in 2004. If you remember before that, there was the tech bubble in 2001. The interest rates at that point were about 6.5%, and they brought them down to 1% by 2003. So they were flat for a long time, and then they started increasing the rates, very low rate. It was the lowest rates in 45 years, started increasing the rates. And this is what happened in 2004 and 2005 when they were increasing interest rates that entire time, is that buyers became more manic, more desperate to buy now before the interest rates increased even more. I'm sure every loan officer in the country was saying, you need to buy now before rates go even higher. So I'm worried that that could happen again. I don't know. There were so many other different things going on in 2004, 2005 that it may not happen this time. But I'm a worrier. I'm worried that it could cause people to move forward their purchases so they can get the better interest rate. And in fact, that could be one reason why we've had so many sales in 2015 was there was a rumor or the conventional wisdom in the fall and the spring was that the Federal Reserve was going to increase rates in the summer. They didn't, but nevertheless, that could have pressed a lot of people to buy then rather than later. Okay, I got a terrible conclusion to this. I don't know what's going to happen to the Phoenix real estate market in 2016. The rate change thing is unknown, what's going on with the markets. As soon as I come to a conclusion on something, I'll do another video. But right now, I don't know. Sorry about that. Man, that was sorry about that, but I got nothing better. But in a way, it is a data point. You know that there's no clear consensus of where the market's going. Thanks, everybody. Take care.